Yes, thank you very much, Comrade Treasure Masopo. Revolutionary greetings to you all, comrades. My name is Comrade Mobisi Tamlambo. I'm a revolutionary intellectual. Today we're in Mtare, at the famous Nichols Park, a colonial monument, a place where capitalism first shed its ugly blood on the people of Zimbabwe in Manicaland. Today I'm with Comrade Treasure Masopo. Pursuant to the recent developments in the country, we are here to give some few comments and obviously proffer the necessary intellectual thought leadership. Comrade Masopo, thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Brother Mlambo, for giving me this chance, this opportunity and the point for me to unpack and, of course, to look into the issues which are bedeviling in our country. I mean, of interest that you've said, Brother. Today we are here in Manicaland province, the eastern part of the country, where revolutionary are brand and they actually
vegetables of this world, the two boys, Edgar Tubo Jekeres of this world.
We are absent from the usual place, the People's Republic of the West of Zimbabwe, which is centered at the epicenter, or the center of a filthy city, which of course once was the capital city of Zimbabwe, which at one point in time we used to be referred to as the Sunshine City.
So you are saying the sun no longer shines?
No, there's no more the sun. It still remains a name which is found in a tourist Broncos.
On a more serious note, Comrade Masopo, we have witnessed the very city developments in the West of Zimbabwe. We have witnessed the so-called thesis of one Grace Mugabe. We have witnessed the extension of a contract for one Professor Levi Nyagura. We've also witnessed the harassment, the purported harassment, according to recent media reports, of University of Zimbabwe Sociology Department lecturers who are questioning the intellectual honesty, the clarity, the serenity, the decency of the university when it brought out Grace Mugabe's PhD thesis. It's unfortunate, it's rather worrying that the university has chosen to give the world a very bogus thesis which cites 2016 and 2017 articles and books, whereas the same is said to have been written in 2014. It's very unfortunate that the University of Zimbabwe has been thrown to the dogs. The University of Zimbabwe is no longer the center for academic excellence. The University of Zimbabwe is no longer a beacon of hope. The University of Zimbabwe is no longer the creme de la creme of the country, as we used to know it when it produced the likes of Professor Arthur Mutambara, when it was under the stewardship of the late Professor Walter J. Kambama, is so rest in peace. They said that Professor Levi Nyagura is running the University of Zimbabwe like a tax shop. It's very unfortunate. It's very, very unfortunate. Comrade Masopo.
Brother, no, one of the key things you have to take note of is that the university should not be run like a tax shop. I mean, the University of Zimbabwe is found upon the principles of constitutionalism. As I say, it's a derivative of the national constitution, since it is an academic institution. There is what we call the University Act, which governs the conduct of the workers there, which governs the conduct of the students, and which governs how the university is supposed to be run. And there is a clear evidence, unrefuted evidence, and unbridled, uncontestable evidence in regards to how a PhD is supposed to be attained.
And all the steps, the necessary steps, the legal steps that are stipulated by the University Act were not only not followed by the so-called Grace Mugabe PhD
Nyagura
writer.
Deliberately abrogated those basic steps.
So in short, Nyagura has violated the same laws that he purported that you would defend.
I know he has violated the oath of office that he took when he was conferred to be the
Vice-Chancellor of the University. And he said that his contract has been extended when it should have ended in 2014.
Yes.
This is a serious concern. So, I mean, there are more competent people to run the University of Zimbabwe.
But look, I think this issue speaks to the issue of the president himself. We have talked with the president before. We have tried to communicate to him through peaceful means, through constitutional means, ways that are civilized. But the president is now disregarding the students' interests. The president, Emmerson Mnangagwa, whom we rightly believe that if we put across our grievance, you address them. But he's quiet, his mom. We wonder, is he conniving with Nyagura? What is his interest?
What was the rationale behind Professor Levi Nyagura's reinstatement or extension, not reinstatement, but extension of his contract as Investor of Zimbabwe Vice Chancellor? Mr. President, I think you are fully aware that when we recorded our video in late December, we stated it categorically clear without any equivocation or ambiguity that one of the primary reasons that the students of the University of Zimbabwe joined the rest of Zimbabweans when we were marching against the dictatorship of Robert Mugabe, one of our concerns, one of our grievances was that Levi Nyagura no longer has this decency, no longer has the serenity, no longer has the competence, no longer has even the must not even have the guts to remain investors of Zimbabwe Vice Chancellor. So it is said, it's a sad development in the broader democratic struggles, the sad development with investors of Zimbabwe that Levi Nyagura has got a contract extension. We then wonder that are there no competent Zimbabweans who can obviously steer the ship at the investors of Zimbabwe and take the investors of Zimbabwe to these heights that it used to be in the 1990s, that it used to be in the early 80s. We want the investors of Zimbabwe to be a five-star university. We want the investors of Zimbabwe to be a center of academic excellence. We want the investors of Zimbabwe to be a place where academic freedom is respected. But so long as Professor Levi Nyagura is still at the helm as Vice Chancellor, we can only say that believing that the university will be a center of academic freedom is just like waiting for God.
Not just a center, but you equally need to remember that we used to say that the University of Zimbabwe is the only university in sub-Saharan Africa. Mm. On the base, that is the only university which has a name which starts with the word the.
Yes.
The university.
The university.
Of course, it's espoused in the university.
Yes.
Equally, the only university in sub-Saharan Africa which is written. Actually, the whole university, in the whole world, which is written in the Bible, Job 1:1.
He was a man in the land of UZ,
yes,
who was called Job. But anyway, on a more serious note, comrades and friends, we are very concerned. The economic situation in the country has not improved. The bank queues are still present, are still visible. The production deficit in the economy is still very visible. We still wait for a clear economic roadmap, a clear economic trajectory that is to be espoused by this government. We want to see a serious investment, we want to see job creation, we want to see the reindustrialization of Mutare. Mutare Board and Paper Mills must reopen, Border Timbers must reopen, Karina must reopen, Mutare Science must reopen. We want to see agricultural production improving in Manicaland, we want to see horticultural projects at Nyanyadzi, what culture projects at Hot Springs. You want to see the revival of Manicaland as a hub of economic activity.
Even the small and medium enterprises.
Yes.
Days when we grew up, we used to know green market.
Yes.
Yes. But these days, you wonder, there is nothing more, and there's no more green.
It's an insult to call it green.
Thank you very much,
thank you very much. We remain the revolutionary intellectuals. Today we are in Mutare,
yes,
the capital of Manicaland, the eastern island, the jewel of Zimbabwe, where you find diamonds, where you find gold, where you find the most arable land in Zimbabwe, where you find the most intelligent people in Zimbabwe. You find them in Manicaland. Has produced the great Professor Adam Jambara, has produced Zimbabwe's first black lawyer, Hebeti Shitefu, has produced people like myself, has produced the brother Treasure Pasuku, has produced Professor Bujganga, Aluta Contra,
Ignorasia,
Moi Comrades Moi,
my name is Ria
Omuyete, in ceremony.
Brother Mlambo, one of the most decorated guys.